Thank you very much. Good afternoon.
You spoke about the need to access the outgoing administration's COVID vaccine distribution plans. What do you see as the biggest threat to your transition right now, given President Trump's unprecedented attempt to obstruct and delay a smooth transfer of power?
More people may die if we don't coordinate. Look, as my chief of staff, Ron Klain, would say, who handled Ebola, a vaccine is important. It's of little use until you're vaccinated. So how do we get the vaccine? How do we get over 300 million Americans vaccinated? What's the game plan? It's a huge, huge, huge undertaking to get it done, prioritize those greatest in need, and working our way through it, and also cooperate with the World Health Organization and the rest of the world in dealing with this. And so they say they have this warp speed program that they not only dealt with getting vaccines, but also how to distribute this. If we have to wait until January 20th to start that planning, it puts us behind over a month, month and a half. And so it's important that it be done, that there be coordination now. Now or as rapidly as we can get that done.
So what are you going to do? What options do you have to try and ensure that you are ready to go on day one?
So it would make it a lot easier if the president were to participate. You have a number of Republicans suggesting that. The good news here is my colleague is still in the Intelligence Committee, so she gets the intelligence briefings. I don't anymore. So but there's a number of Republicans calling for that. I am hopeful that the president will be mildly more enlightened before we get to January 20th.
And what is your message to Republicans who are backing up the president's refusal to concede? You clearly need to work with them going forward.
My message is I will work with you. I understand a lot of your reluctance because of the way the president operates, but I've been in contact with and will be in contact with more of them as we move along. And if it has to wait until January 20th to get actually become operational, that's a shame, but maybe that's the only way to get it done. That is Trumpianism. No change in his modus operandi. I'm having a lot of meetings with world leaders on the telephone. I cannot get into negotiating with them about things that are going to be done, but they're calling with some degree of enthusiasm. Everyone from the Holy Father to prime ministers across the globe. And so we're moving along knowing what the outcome will be. And as I said earlier, and I probably shouldn't repeat it, but I find this more embarrassing for the country than debilitating for my ability to get started. Mary Kay Henry, president of SEIU. Mark Perrone, president of UFCW. But I wouldn't hesitate to get the vaccine if, in fact, Dr. Fauci and these two organizations, whether it's Moderna or Pfizer, who have been extremely responsible, conclude that it is safe and able to be done. Look, the only reason people question the vaccine now is because of Donald Trump. That's the reason why people are questioning the vaccine, because all the things he says and doesn't say, whether it's truthful, is it not truthful, the exaggerations. I think we're on a clear path now. We're on a clear path with the international community and national leaders in the scientific community have focused on these two vaccines. They appear to be ready for prime time, ready to be used. And if that continues along those roads, I would take the vaccine. Vital public services, running law enforcement offices.